I think everything I have is what he's given. What we have today also is what we got from him. You want to know him as a person. See, I'm describing him as how I knew him. See, he was a dad. And he was a busy man.
What was it like to your mother? What was she like? How was she as a person?
She was also a very nice person, and then she was, but she was quite a disciplinarian, you know, she wanted
disciplined for us to be disciplined in.
Yes.
Discipline in the sense of, you know, you have to behave like this.
We have to behave like this and do all the things, you know, like as we grew up, you know, she would say you go and check on things and, you know, manage your own, you know, like that. She made us quite independent, actually. I'm happy for that. Even forms, when my sister and myself, when we went to college, she didn't send somebody else with the form, including my brother. She said, you all take your forms, wait in the queue and fill it up and give it in the college. So Meenakshi, myself and my brother, we gave in our forms ourselves. No one else went on behalf to give the... See, she was very particular like that.
So even for me, I had to go and give my forms, everything.
She was very South Indian in her dressing style. And you know those days how they wore sari, and then she always wore that waist belt, the gold waist belt, and while my father was there. Of course, then
after he passed away, even she was like my grandmother. She didn't wear any jewelry or anything. Very simple.
She always told me one thing in Kannada, that saying, no? Tan madad uttama, aal madad halu, maga madad madhyam, you know, that sort of thing. Always she drilled into my mind. She all, because sometimes we used to not do what she said and say, I told somebody else to do it. You know, that thing of doing things yourself was very important to her. Her day used to start, she was also quite busy. People used to come to see her, visitors and all that. So morning, that usual ritualistic puja and all that. And one thing about my mother, she was very fond of singing. She was quite accomplished. She sang also very well.
And she used to play the veena also quite well. Yeah. Very well, actually.
And I remember one of my early memories of her was when Gayatri, my sister, got married, then Subbalakshmi had come. So then Subbalakshmi wanted to hear her sing also. So she had come to the private apartments to hear her sing. And yes, because her aunt, that's her mother's sister, was also a very good singer. Her name, we used to call her Pache. I don't know what her real name was, because I told you in our community people had those names.
Lot of
Pache,
names.
Hito, Ranbuddhi, Adho, you know, those sort of names. So real name gets lost.
So
this
her sister.
No, mother's sister.
She was
her aunt.
Aunt.
What was her daily dressing like?
Her daily dressing, she used to be in silks most of the time.
Mysore silks. So I think for most of you it was Mysore silks.
Mysore silks only.
Where would the clothes come from?
I think from that silk factory it used to come quite a lot. And then sometimes Kanjivarams and all that also she used to wear. Dharmavaram silk, that lighter silk.
Do you have any of her saris?
I have few saris. But my saris are not the silk ones. I have the Mysore saris I have. Those are that with that small border.
It's a small gold border.
Gold border, you know, that Sannanchan Sire they used to call.
No, her saris.
Her saris only.
Okay. Were they specially woven for her?
No, I think they used to make it for everyone, because most people used to buy those type of saris.
And she had also studied, I think.
She had done only 10th SSLC, and she was very proficient in Kannada, more than English actually. Kannada, this Puranas, Giranas and all she used to read. Yeah, she was also fairly busy because people used to come and visit her. And
was she also involved in some form of work or?
Not work, but you know, social work, I suppose she was. But there were a lot of visitors coming to see her.
So many
for help. I suppose social work, only help. And
come for some functions, they wanted to
invitations
have
and all that. So.
And all that.
Then she would be, she would she practice her music every day?
Or? She used to practice her music every day.
And she didn't teach
in the
theater?
No, no, she
or
didn't
teach. Not interested.
Your brother was in piano and all that?
Yeah, he liked the guitar and piano and all that. But singing, she was good in singing. Actually, we didn't
actually,
take any interest.
My younger sister, she
learned to sing also.
To sing and another person is, I mean, she didn't learn to sing, but she's got a very good voice in singing and all that. Only two of them.
Some classical music and my mother was very fond of all the Devnamas. Her favorite song, which I remember always, is that Sakala Grahapala Nine.
And what was her ritual like? You said she was very ritualistic.
Yes, her pujas and then, you know, then have her breakfast.
He was a pekin too.
And she was a vegetarian, pure vegetarian.
He was a pekin to your Devamani.
Sorry.
Was it?
My Devamani used to be full of photographs and...
all those small, I mean, Chamandeshwari idol and Shiva, everything, all those silver idols they had. And she used to sit and do all the pujas. And the Purait used to come. There was one Purait for her and there was a Purait for my father. They used to come and say all the mantras and everything. And they used to do their pujas and get up.
No, his puja room was different, hers was different.
Oh, okay.
It's always been like that, the ladies' puja room and the Maharaja's puja room.
Uh-huh. What, was there any difference, fundamental difference in the puja
room? Yes, lot of difference was there.
Yeah.
His was a bigger puja room.
This was very big.
Very big, even now it is very big. And hers was not
was
that
smaller.
Big, but small. And this thing. She used to have bath. There was a bathing room there near the puja room. So she used to have a bath and then go there and do her pujas, everything. Meanwhile, the Purait used to wait for her to come. As soon as she came, and they would start the puja, everything. And finish by, I think, 8:30, no? 8:30 or something.
Nine.
And then she used to come up and have her breakfast. And then all the visitors used to come at 10 o'clock.
What was the royal kitchen like?
Our kitchen was different.
The kitchen was that Birdi I told you, no? That was the
that
kitchen
was the
for
thing.
Both.
We never went that side, mm-hmm. rather.
No.
So what would a typical breakfast be?
There used to be all the South Indian breakfast, whatever.
Idli, dosa, vada and puri.
Vada's not so much because it's not considered very auspicious. There was already a fixed menu, so on this day that's... you know, something dosas would come and then another day something else like that. My mother used to have breakfast in her room. We all used to have it together, the children.
With dad?
Yeah, with my father.
With father?
Yeah.
And there would be a lot of servants serving you? And
yes, there would be serving. Not a lot of servants, one or two would come and serve.
If you want to recollect, how was life in the palace, in the Mysore palace? What was it like?
No, I don't know. I suppose grand maybe, but it was also, it was quite normal, the lifestyle. The only thing is we had servants, a lot of servants, because the place was huge.
Was it very normalized when you went to college?
Yes, quite normal, I think. By the
How
time I was...
How did others address you?
No, by name only. We were not addressed as so and so and all that. Everyone addressed us, called us, even in college, by name.
If we go back to remembering the Maharaja, must have been a very, very large influence on both.
To tell you the truth, he was a very awesome person, you know. He had such a personality because he was big and we were all small. So you feel he had that something in him which made him stand out. He was very fond of reading, which we all liked. He used to read a lot of books on philosophy, but we didn't read at that time. Now it's different, life is different, so you read philosophical books as you grow older. He had one of those rarest, this Patek Philippe watch he collected. My son knows all the details because he keeps a track on everything. So he was telling me it's one of 600 watches they made, or 700, like it was a limited edition. Or 100 something, I'm not very sure. But he said that. And he was very fond of watches, my father. He collected a lot of watches.
What were his other pet passions? Pens, watches, cars?
Cars also he had, no? Pens, I don't know. Pens, he must have liked Parker pens because he used to write a lot. One more thing I remember, going to Bombay, and we had once stayed in that earlier the Raj Bhavan guest house, and then going shopping with him to that bookshop in the Taj Mahal Hotel. There used to be a bookshop in the Taj Mahal Hotel which was very famous, going shopping with him. But I remember he bought us all those Baba books. Not this Baba, not our Baba. This is, the elephant was called Baba and he was a king. And you know those stories, I remember getting one like that as a child from him, from that Bombay. Maybe because I was small and picked it up to see the pictures also. Sort of cartoon type. It's American edition. Printed, but handwritten. I used to love that because it was all handwritten. He had got it for me there from that shop. And we had some collection in our
school library.
There were a lot of books in our school library. Then my mother donated it to
the Good Shepherd Convent.
Orphanage. We used to call him Daddy.
Daddy.
We were quite anglicized. Daddy and my mother, we called her Mama. And my grandmother, we used to call her Granny. I think they, even my father called his father Daddy. They were all, you know. And I think a granduncle they used to call Dodappa. Dodappa ji, not Dodappa, Dodappa ji. That.
So, your childhood with your dad, I still haven't been able to get much details from you in terms of how dad was for you both.
See, he was a dad. And he was a busy man. And you see, what happened, we were all quite young actually, unfortunately, when we lost him. By the time when you grow up, then you really know what a person is like, or you start. I was 17, I got married and went away. So he died when I was 20. You want to know him as a person. See, I'm describing him as how I knew him. See, now if you met him, your perception would be different. We know him
as a father.
As a father figure and this thing. So what I feel is the best thing about him, he was a good and kind person and very humane. See, that's the most important thing in a person, when you feel for somebody else. You felt for the people. He's helped a lot of people. That's why I think people remember him so much, even now after all these years have gone. He was basically very thoughtful, kind. I remember him like that. He's a thoughtful and kind person. He's given each one of us a Dattatreya book. See, Dattatreya because we belong to the Atreya Gotra. Atreya Gotra is, his guru was Dattatreya. So it's a very high philosophical book where really nothing means nothing. It's like the Vedant when you go. Actually, after you study the Vedanta, you come to the conclusion there's really nothing. So, it's like that. So, you have to go to that higher level of thinking. I've read a little bit of it. But it's very high in thinking. And it's mostly about the soul, connection with your own Atma. So, how connected you get. So, it's very high philosophy. So, to get in touch with yourself. The most important thing in life is to get in touch with yourself. He wrote about it. He went in depth into it and he was able to understand it and bring it. And he had written a letter when I was small he had gone to the Shakespeare's place. So you can say that's one of my most valued possessions. I think everything I have is what he's given. What we have today also is what we got from him. So I cherish everything, including him.